What's going on, y'all? Jimmy Macrum, Marcus Cash. It's time for Office Space. I know quite a bit about this movie. I know Dr. Cox is in it.
Oh, which one is that?
Jesus, the mean one.
No. I know that. His real life name.
John C. McGinley.
Okay.
Apparently, Jim Francis is in it, and I've seen a couple of those like clips.
You blow past Jennifer Aniston.
Go ahead. You want to jerk off? I don't think they can see you below your waist. Though, don't fuck up my couch, please.
I won't go past here.
I totally got distracted.
The rebuttal.
I know you've seen this clip before, though, because I got the glass.
Yeah.
That. And obviously, John C. McGinley going, yeah, I'm going to need you to pack up your desk or whatever the fuck he says.
Yeah.
That shit is fucking hilarious.
The Office Space memes are fantastic, always.
Indeed. Anyway. Press the red button. Mike Judge? I had no idea.
Go!
If any of you are fans of rock or soul music, his series, Tales from the Tour Bus, where he animates outrageous fucking stories, is fantastic.
This already feels very perfectly 90s.
It feels very Mike Judge.
Can we get it, Paul Dano? When it comes to this gangsta shit, you motherfuckers know who run it. We're standing up
for our own shit. That's fucking fantastic. This guy's in a...
No, Aziz is super angry.
I love how you're randomly racist. And you're just like, that's funny. Oh! Oh, Jesus, he lost a lot of weight in recent years. You ever seen Barry?
Barry?
Yeah.
Barry from where?
I know, Barry, the fucking assassin TV show.
Oh, no.
Skews.
My Porsche.
Of course it is.
Oh, please do McGinley.
No, it's fucking, what's his name? Fuck, what is his name?
I'm pretty sure he's the guy that was the first name on the fucking listing.
Ron Livingston? No, it's the guy in the car. He was in Entourage for a little bit. Because of a sad existence. Luckily, they get rid of those.
Get rid of what?
They'll get rid of cubicles. People are deciding to work from home. Thanks to the pandemic, thank God. Just a moment.
Some of them reopened. My old job reopened.
I'm not saying they're fucking extinct.
If you could just go ahead and make sure you do that from now on, that would be great. And, I'll go ahead and make sure you get another copy of that memo. Okay?
Yeah, no, I have the memo. I've got it. It's right.
Hello. Oh, I thought that was McGinley. That's not. That's whoever that guy's name I can't remember is.
We've had so many of those managers, have we not?
Oh.
It's just we're putting new cover sheets on all the TPS reports before they go out now. So if you could go ahead and try to remember to do that from now on, that'd be great. All right.
Ugh. I think a nice manager might be worse.
I already hate working here, and I don't work here.
Same.
Yes. I have the memo. What if we're still doing this when we're 50?
It would be nice to have that kind of job security.
I think that the guy might actually be able to help. I mean, he did help Anne lose weight.
Peter, she's anorexic.
Yeah, I know. The guy's really good. Lawrence, can't you just pretend like we can't hear each other through the wall?
Oh, sorry, man. Anne over there or something?
No, but if you want to talk to me, just come over.
Hey, man.
I love this guy.
The guy's in everything. Jesus.
Doesn't that chick look like Anne?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, my God, is it Anne?
Sometimes I get the feeling like she's cheating on me.
Yeah, I get that feeling too, man.
What do you mean by that?
I just get that feeling looking at her like... She's the type of chick that would just...
Says, what would you do if you had $1 million?
I'll tell you what I'd do, man. Two chicks at the same time, man. And I think if I were a millionaire, I could hook that up, too, because chicks dig dudes with money.
Well, not all chicks.
Well, the type of chicks that double up on a dude like me do.
Then I'm quitting. I'm going to quit. And I told Dom, too, because they've moved my desk 4 times already this year, and I used to be over by the window.
Glasses are preposterous.
Okay, Milton. And, oh, no, it's not okay, because if they make me
if they take my stapler, then I'll have to set the building on fire.
Okay, well, that sounds great. I'll talk to you later. All right, bye.
I think Mill is my least favorite character so far.
That's hilarious. I don't know what came out first, this or the Matrix, but it feels like that scene in the beginning of the Matrix.
I want you to relax every muscle in your body, beginning with your toes to your fingertips.
This guy's giving me big time Jason Alexander vibes. George Costanza?
I don't know who George Costanza is. I'm just shocked at the fucking blasphemy. How dare you?
You can't imagine George doing this role? Same mannerisms, talk.
Your worries, cares, and inhibitions will be gone. And you will remain in that state until I snap my fingers.
Is he having a heart attack?
Yeah, I think so.
Way, way down.
Oh, he's getting off on this one, so I can't figure it out.
Way down. One.
Oh my God, Dr. Swanson!
Oh, is he hypnotized permanently?
What?
Let's go. I don't know if I've ever woken up that heavy.
Peter, what's going on?
Huh?
It's 3:30. Why aren't you at work?
Because I didn't feel like it.
Peter, what's gotten into you? First you just sit there while Dr. Swanson dies, then you just walk out of the car and embarrass me in front of my friends. And don't blame this on hypnosis either. That's total bull.
What are you doing for lunch today?
Well, our specials today are blackened chicken, and it's actually right there on the board. Excuse me.
Hey, look who's back. Table for three.
I'm gonna go next door and get a table, and if you'd like to join me, no big deal, all right? And if not, that's cool, too.
Very smooth, sir.
When you say next door, do you mean Chili's or Flingers?
Flingers.
Okay.
Does that work?
What would you say you do here?
Well, look, I already told you. I deal with the goddamn customers so the engineers don't have to. I have people skills. I am good at dealing with people. Can't you understand that?
To be fair, his job is really worthless.
So you're gonna quit?
Nuh-uh, not really. I'm just gonna stop going.
I've done that before.
Yeah, a lot more recent than I cared to.
What are you gonna do about money and bills and...
You know, I've never really liked paying bills.
I love this guy.
And a bum. What do you mean?
You should come over and watch Kung Fu tonight.
Okay.
Great.
Okay. Can we order lunch first?
Yeah.
How lucky is that?
Who is this? You like Kung Fu? And she's like, yeah, sure. You're gonna be a bum, but I'll come over.
Peter, you're in deep shit. You were supposed to come in on Saturday. What were you doing?
Michael, I did nothing. I did absolutely nothing, and it was everything that I thought it could be. The thing is, Bob, it's not that I'm lazy. It's that I just don't care.
Don't care?
I love how long this has gone because they're so mystified about this.
But what if you were offered some kind of a stock option equity sharing program? Would that do anything for you?
I don't know, I guess. Listen, I'm gonna go.
The pleasure's all on this side of the table, trust me.
Did he end up changing the whole fucking company because they're gonna fire a bunch of mid management?
No. Peter, what's happening? Listen.
We feel that the problem isn't with Peter.
Mm-mm.
It's that you haven't challenged him enough to get him really motivated.
There it is. Yeah.
Yeah, Bill, let me ask you
a quick
question here. How much time would you say you spend each week dealing with these TPS reports?
Yeah.
It's like the corporate version of Fargo.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my God. Oh wait, did they just give it to him?
No, he took it. Oh, the job?
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't think so. He might be right. That's bold thing for fucking hypno fucking Peter.
And they like to avoid confrontation, so maybe they didn't fire him. They didn't let him know he was fired.
So, Peter.
He's playing Tetris.
So you're gonna fire Michael and Samir and you're gonna give me more money?
Hmm? Well, Samir and I are the best programmers they got at that place.
It's completely unfair. And I realized something today. It's not just about me and my dream of doing nothing, it's about all...
We have to swear to God, Allah, that nobody knows about this but us, all right? No family members, no girlfriends,
all the neighbors.
Nobody.
Of course.
Agreed.
Don't worry, man, I won't tell anyone either.
What the fuck is that?
No call.
Right, I see it. You named it Virus? Oh my god.
Here comes the big headed nigga that's dipping, sipping on Kobasi. Goddamn, I must have the floss today. Now pimping ain't easy, but it's necessary. So
I miss you, I gotta be honest.
Time chase Jerry. I put the
that was a great face.
My two-tone Ford Explorer, you know how it's done.
This is a real song one is made for this movie, because this sounds preposterous.
All 90s rap sounds preposterous.
It's like even slower than anything I've heard.
He goes home and tries to kill himself by running the car in the garage. Is he dead? No, oh, man, check it out. That wife of his comes home early from work and catches him. He decides he wants to live.
Yeah, I think I'm okay.
Oh, that's sweet. I was getting a car accident.
But then as soon as he backs out of his driveway.
Is he okay?
Sort of. He broke both his wrists, legs, a couple of ribs, his back.
Jesus.
He's getting out of the hospital tomorrow and he's gonna throw a big party this weekend to celebrate. We're all invited. I'm thinking I might take that new chick from logistics. Things go well, I might be showing her my O face. Oh. You know what I'm talking about. Oh.
He stings.
Is this where the show me your O face came from?
Is it? It can't be.
I'm mad he's doing a whole axe kick.
Samir's fantastic. Fucking ow.
Yeah, no, what are you doing?
I
kept a piece of cable with him. What? Samir can't get gold, but he's fucking placing so hard.
Hey, what were you guys celebrating last night?
Alright, so when the subroutine compounds the interest, right, it uses all these extra decimals.
I won't give him a pass to the Jennifer Aniston still.
Doesn't it bother you that you have to get up in the morning and you have to put on a bunch of pieces of flair?
Yeah, but I'm not about to go in and start taking money from the register.
Well, maybe you should. You know, the Nazis had pieces of flair, but they made the Jews wear.
Jesus, he jumped.
Did you just alienate Jennifer Aniston? You dolt.
Just remember, if you hang in there long enough, good things can happen in this world. I mean, look at me.
Thanks, Tom.
All you need is a positive outlook in life.
How much is medical bills going to be?
Well, I don't really feel like doing that.
I just sleep with Lumberg.
What? I mean, what are you? You think you're some kind of, like, angel here? No, you're just this penny-stealing, wannabe criminal man. Why don't you just call me when you grow up?
Oh, wow.
Wait, you know what? That's probably never gonna happen, so just don't call me, okay?
Say hello to Lumberg!
Maybe don't say hello to Lumberg, who she could probably tell that you're stealing.
Jesus, that's what you got from that?
Now Lumberg,
he also has no innovations right now, by the way.
Oh my god.
Alright, what is he gonna do?
Has it broken his hypnosis, by the way?
No, he's gonna do something stupid because he's got no inhibitions. That was quick.
Michael, you said the thing was gonna take 2 years. What happened? You said the thing was supposed to work.
Technically, it did work.
No, it didn't.
Did not work, Michael. Okay?
Okay.
He added zero.
I must try to figure this thing out together. The first thing we gotta do is we gotta close that account before it gets any bigger.
To be fair, even if you move a decimal, what is that, $35,000? You move two places, it's $33,000, rather? Like, you missed a few decimals there, buddy.
The lack of feeling is fantastic.
The fact that Milton is still here is outrageous. You're not getting paid.
His neck is so filthy on that shirt.
Now, Milton, don't be greedy. Let's pass it along and make sure everyone gets a piece.
He's not getting a piece.
Last time I didn't receive a piece, and I was told that
just
I
just pass.
Okay.
He's not getting a piece. Take your piece and run, sir.
We need you upstairs right away. We got a big problem. Big. Some major glitch in accounting. A lot of money missing. We got an investigator here.
Who's that? All right, nobody panic. Probably just Lawrence.
It's not Lawrence.
Good evening, sir. My name is Steve. I used to be addicted to crack, but now I'm off and trying to stay clean.
Okay.
That is why I'm selling magazine subscriptions.
No.
And
no,
I was hoping that you could help me out.
You used to be addicted to crack?
Yeah,
What is his name? He's hilarious.
Yeah, Jose Orlando something?
Sounds right.
You just give us the name of one drug dealer. I mean, I could talk to him. I have good networking skill.
I lied. All the stuff I said about being a crackhead just helps me sell magazines. Actually, an unemployed software engineer.
Jesus. Wait a minute. You're not going to tell anybody about all this stuff we told you. I mean, we know a lot of the same people. That's...
That all depends.
What am I going to do with 40 subscriptions to Vibe?
He just wanted 40 subscriptions instead of a cut?
You are a very bad person, Peter.
Jesus. I know you're upset, but goddamn. You need to call Joanna, like yesterday.
Yeah. Assuming she answers and... Hadn't changed your number or have you blocked or both?
You want to come over?
But those happened one of 8 times.
Mars is hilarious.
I may never be happy at my job, but I think that if I could be with you, that I could be happy with my life. I've been a real asshole. If you could give it another shot, I promise okay, you, Joanna.
That easy?
Whoa, hey, what's going on here? Get a room, you two.
That guy's hilarious. I mean, I hate a gentleman, that guy's hilarious.
Fuck.
Milton burns the place down. Milton burns the place down.
Please. You gonna break this door? Didn't you already take a drill to a door before?
Mr. Lumberg told me to talk to payroll, and then payroll told me to talk to Mr. Lumberg.
Where does one find a check and take it?
I'm just gonna have to take my paper back because it's my paper and I don't miss it. It's my paper.
Oh shit!
Wait, was it open the whole time?
I mean, I'm sure it was. I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe the secretary opened it? Well, he just opened it, like unlocked it.
Well. Time to go face the music. You take care of yourself all if right. I don't see you, all right?
You too, man. Take care of you, bud. Right. Hey, Peter.
Yeah?
Watch out for your cornhole, bud.
That's beautiful. Thank you, stupid. Jesus.
Every crime show's correct. The guy who did it is in the crowd, trying to watch.
I wonder if the money burned up. It would be a shame.
Yeah.
So you sure you don't want us to get your job?
That's one thing I'm definitely sure of.
Most of the money was in the account. It's already in the account, right?
Yeah.
Did he save the $300,000 and ice him out?
Jesus fucking Christ.
I'm saying, is that why he's c- content working construction?
No, I think it's because he hated his job.
Making bucks, getting exercise, working outside.
Sounds awful.
Fucking A. Fucking A.
We'll find out right now.
How do we know? This is a $300,000 vacation? It's not a $100,000 vacation?
He found the checks.
No salt for the margarita, but it had salt on it.
There's big grains
of salt on the end of my family again. I won't be leaving a tip. I could shut this whole resort down.
I have to write a letter to your board of tourism and I could have this place condemned.
All right, that was Office Space. I cannot get over where Jennifer Aniston looks. It's a little disturbing. She's aged well, by the way.
She's one of my identity crushes that have survived the test of time.
I don't know why survived the test of time sounds preposterous. Well, she had pushing 50 at this point.
Oh, yeah.
But that's 99.
90 might be pushed, quite frankly.
She's 20-something. She still looks great. I don't know if she would begin with the fucking movie. It was
ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
Oh, ridiculous. But not over the top ridiculous like some things we've seen, so. Watch a lot of fucking yeah.
Oh, like Fargo. Yeah, to me this clearly wasn't on that level of ridiculous. This or that level of quality, quite frankly. But that's fun. It's a fun little hour and a half movie.
It's a good Mike Judge production.
Yes. Oh, fucking King of the Hill. Which is Mike Judge became Mike Judge.
At least King of the Hill for me.
Huh?
I never really loved King of the Hill.
Fair enough. I did like this movie. I liked almost all of the characters. Even Milton grew up by the end. Yeah, I have no complaints.
Awards?
Just a creepy smile.
Awards?
You have nothing else to say?
This movie was fun. It was a lot of fun. I didn't know what the hell to expect.
Bursting at the seams for his MVPs. This is going to be how ridiculous this is going to be. Jesus.
I don't have anything formulated. I'm struggling here. That's all I need to hear from you.
MVP is Peter, with relative ease. Carried the movie, and he was hilarious. That's all I asked for. Lumberg is number two, for being purely hilarious. And Joanne is three, because Jennifer Aniston. I guess Milton, the other two, and Bill number one. Bill or Bob? Bob. And Bob number one, they would get honorable mention, but Jennifer Lawrence got a place. I'm sorry. Jennifer Aniston has got a place.
Both Jennifers. I guess Peter's the gold, or being the star, and being the protagonist? Am I using that right? Protagonist? Main star, not a villain?
Well, you can be a villain and a protagonist, but yes, the main person. The person driving the action.
Yeah, being the driver. I guess Peter, he was funny. I loved him without inhibitions. That shit was great.
That's so weird.
Especially just doing shit in the office. No, I didn't feel like coming in. I'm not here for long. I gotta go meet with my bosses and get promoted.
That might be the best part, is him having that conversation with his bosses. Like, all laissez-faire. Ends up going hours. And they're just sitting there listening.
And he changed the whole fucking scheme of the company. So that was dope. I think I'm gonna give the silver to Lawrence.
Okay.
Fucking A, man. That guy's hilarious.
He's hilarious. Is he on Whose Line Is It Anyway?
No. He's Ryan. You're thinking Ryan Stiles. He always.
No, I'm not thinking about Ryan Stiles, sir. Thank you. Ryan Stiles is 8 feet tall.
Well, they were on the Drew Carey Show together. But that's the only connection he would have with anything on Whose Line.
That's what I'm about. The Drew Carey Show, yes. You think about Ryan Stiles. No, I'm not. You think about Ben Affleck. What? No, I'm not.
Shouts out to Ryan Stiles. Yeah, I got Lawrence going for the silver, and then I've got for the bronze, I think we can give the bronze to Milton.
Really? You went from your least favorite character to the bronze?
Just because, A, he saved the day, he preserved Peter's gold, right? Because okay. If Peter gets caught, he drops down that list significantly.
That's outrageous. That's he makes out work. So
he's missing money, he gets his money several times over.
This is true.
He burns down the place he hates like he wanted, and now he's living the fucking life. Without having to get himself fucking wrecked like the other guy.
Which this is true. Though to be fair, they still fucked this margarita up. Big giant salt on the sides.
They might get burned down too, but that's besides the point.
LVP?
You know, I was going to say Lumberg, but now I just justified Milton. What's the guy in the wheelchair now?
Tom?
It might be Tom.
Stop it. Tom's a millionaire.
Rather than Lumberg.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Because he's...
He is out of this cush job. He's been fucking... He's a bought him a Porsche, by the way.
He's out of his cush job, fucking do nothing mid management fucking schmuck.
Yeah, he was awful.
Right?
We're in agreement.
And turns out he did not fuck Jennifer Aniston. So
You can't give him LVP based on something he didn't do and didn't even know he was supposed to do.
Yeah, but it's a lack of W's.
It's definitely a lack of W's. So he got Jennifer Aniston at some point. That's
he edges out Milton.
Fair enough.
Are you worth more than a few travel checks?
That's hilarious. Plug?
Jennifer Aniston.
What the fuck?
Please.
I apologize for my friend here. It is my channel, so I do take responsibility for what's going on in this channel. I don't push it off on anybody else because I'm an asshole. I hate him so much. Post your comments down below. Like, share, subscribe.